All right, so today I'm going to talk about a few ways of gathering, coordinating, trying to be kind, I'm in a grumpy mood, ways of coordinating these cob collectibles, I'll call you, where you have very similar to the Talos Earthship community, where it's all zoned, Earthships only. We'll make subdivisions that are just cob construction, super adobe only. So we just have a good, beneficial building area with less flack, just easier for everybody, easier for even the inspectors, blah blah blah. Okay, so we have to think about, we don't have a magazine. There's not a Cobb Construction magazine. I don't believe so. That would be something if somebody wants to start one, similar to Mother Earth News. You know, you could have like a design of the month type of deal. You can have exposés on, but we have so much online. We do have so much online. We do have a lot of good online that, you know, I mean, it's almost like, why do we need a magazine? You know, are we just blind that we can't see the simple, these simple, you know, people walking through their houses? You know, it's already there. So those are great. People have done that. Okay, so we need to gather the people, and I'm thinking like a mailing list. How do you get a mailing list out of these people? Now, if we look at our online subscribers, we're looking at, how do we get YouTube to actually have a mailing list subscriber? Yes, I want to be on your mailing list. So if you sign up to that one, what was it, hardcore sustainable? I want to be on your mailing list. So then that's kind of cool. That's kind of cool. So maybe that would be a feature for YouTube to add, is a mailing list. Because if you think about it, you know, if you have your 50,000 subscribers, they all want to build cob houses, or they are building cob houses. My God, talk about, you know, that's your list. That's the honey, you know, that's the honey for the movement. And so if we can just gather those people as buyers for the land and purchasers, blah blah blah. Okay, so we're looking at dun da da da, and that's it. That's all I had. That's all I wrote down. No, the colleges. So now back to colleges themselves. That's another place on their billboards there that they have at schools, is to actually make waiting lists, not necessarily waiting lists, but commitment to purchase lists. Commitment to purchase land of ecological building and sustainable housing. So when we're thinking about that, we have like, well, that makes it obvious. And so that would be local colleges. And so you gather da-da-da-da-da, and those will be your neighbors one day. Isn't that interesting? So you gather that list of people, say, yeah, I want to build a sustainable property, a cob construction, and be like the Taos Earthships, or be the cob zone. And so when you have that, you're like, dantare, 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 you have your 10 or 20 people, and then there you go then those people are saying, hey, go ahead and spam me with the land choices. Tell me which lands are we really, really voting on. Then that group gets to vote on the land and where, and it's a very simple process. So we can do this again and again and again and mimic it over and over, university to university to university to university. It becomes an across the United States and across Europe type of momentum. So you vote on the properties, you come up with, you know, 10 properties to subdivide or you know, purchase outright. And then there you go. You have your collective vote moment, where you vote and you're like, yeah, we're going to all pay $8,000 each. You know, we just love this property, and there's 20 of us, and we're paying $8,000 each, and it's a, I don't know, 140 acres. And so that's the way you all went and decided. And that's that. And then you pick out your little spot on the map, and that's the way it goes. And it's a commitment to build that type of property anytime in your lifetime. You don't even have to. You can just buy the property. Know that you could one day. And know that some are going to start immediately and some aren't. And that's just the way it goes. But that's a very, very, very good way of selecting ecological neighbors. Now, unfortunately, that group is, you know, they're just the young, they're the young group, and it does push out the middle age. It does push out the older middle agers. So, but at least that, you know, what if we get them, to do such simple things, and I mean, I'm talking simple. If we get them to do such simple things, they can help us, these middle agers, get coordinated and have formations. Because we don't have that environment of a university or a college, do we? That's the problem. Once we're out of that college, out of that university environment, where are you? You're in debt land with the mortgage of your bank. You know, that's where you are. And so you're all panicked. You know, so no, we can't really find you. It's not that same. It's not that simple. So yeah, we need to. It's all about the grouping, you know, grouping of our little collectibles here. Okay. So anyway, I will make a little book. I will try. I'm just booked out. I've made so many books lately. I'm tired, but I'll make a book of little cob designs, houses of little cob designs, and I'll try to make them really pretty. And that will be, I don't know, maybe something I'll use for Kindle, and that can help the what do we call it, this momentum. But yeah, I really like the super adobe combo with the cob also, especially for women, because, you know, it's tough. It's tough, heavy building. Anyway, dantaria, that's it for today. Yeah.